So here we have our project, and in this project we have an assets folder in which we have these three images, and after that we have registered them in our pubspec.yaml file assets section. And after that in the lib folder we have these two files. In the main.dart file we have this main method and a stateless widget which is returning our material app, and in the constant file we have these two colors which we are going to use in our application. So now to display our screen we have to create another file and name it onboarding.dart and make it stateful. So onboarding, and after that simply save it. Now go back to your main.dart file, and here in the home property pass your onboarding screen, save it. And after saving we have our onboarding screen here. If we want to see, you can simply change this to scaffold, and here in the body section use a container for now, save it. And here is our onboarding screen. Go back to your main method, and now we have to remove this status bar color. For that type system chrome in your main method dot set system overlay style, and in here use system overlay style, and here use status bar color and change it to colors.transparent. And after that we have to change the color of our icons. For that change status bar color brightness and change it to brightness.dark, save it. And after restarting we have removed the color, and the color of our icons are black now. Okay, so come back to your onboarding screen, and in the body section remove the body and say column, because now we want to divide our screen into equal parts. For that I will use an expanded widget, and just for UI I will change the color to colors.red, and just copy it again and change the color to green, save it. So now our screen is divided into 50% and 50%. Now we have to divide the second container, which is 50%, into 25-25. For that simply wrap this container into a column, and again wrap this column into an expanded widget, and just simply copy it and paste it and change the color, so amber. Now this is 50%, 25 and 25. In this 50% we are going to display our image, and in this 25 we are going to display our title and about, and in this 25% we are going to display the dots and a button. If you want to increase their size you can change the flex, so flex to. Come back to your red part, and here use a decoration and box decoration, and change the color to BG color, the which we created in our constant folder. And after that we have to round the radius from the bottom. For that use border radius and border radius dot vertical, and from bottom radius dot circular 80, save it. Okay, after that we have to use the child property of our container and show a image dot asset, and now we have to pass the address, so that is assets dot 0.png, save it. And this is our image. Now we have to resize it, so just simply pass width 230 here. Okay, so now you can see there is some issue with the UI. To fix that simply go to your container and change the alignment to alignment.center. So now our red part is completed. Come to this green part, and now we have to display the title and about. For that go back to your constant folder, and here create a list of titles and pass the titles in that. So I will just simply create a list. So this is a list with three titles, as we have three images, and for these titles we have created these about. This is also a list with the about of all these, and just save it. Come back to your onboarding screen, and here in the green section you can simply use a padding here. So edge inset start all side, and it will be 16 from all sides. And after that, use a child property and column, and here use children, and use a text widget to display the title. So as this was a list, we can access the titles according to index. So I will just say titles and pass 0 here. Save it. You can see this is our title. Now we have to style it. So text style, and change the font size to 24 and font weight to font weight dot w700. Save it. So this is our title. After that, we have to just copy this text widget again, paste it, and change the titles to abouts, and change the font size to 16. Also change their color. So for title, we have to change the color to color start black 87, and for about, change the color to color start black 54, and remove this bold from here. So this is our about here. Now we have to align the about in center. For that, go to your text widget and say text align, and text align dot center. It will make it in center. Now to add space between these two, go back to your column and change the main axis alignment to space evenly. Okay, now our second section is also completed. So come to our yellow part, and here we have to simply remove the color and leave it. Now just simply copy this column and cut it. Create another file and say screen widget dot dot, and you can use any widget. I will go with stateless and say screen widget. And here in the return property, I will return the whole column and just import everything. Okay, now come back to our onboarding, and here in the body section, we have to use a stack widget. And in this stack widget children, the first children will be page view builder, and here we have to pass context and index. And now we can return our screen widget here. Save it. Oh, let me just align it. Okay, now in this page view builder, we have to pass controller item count and on page changes method, all these. For that, let's create some controllers and variables. So first will be our int, and say page index will be equal to 0 by default. And after that, create a page controller and name it page controller. So we will initialize it later. After that, go back to your page view builder, and here in the controller property, pass your page controller. Save it. It will cause some error because it is not initialized. So we have to initialize it first. For that, create init state, and here in the init state, initialize your controller is equal to page controller, and here say initial page is equal to our page index, which is 0. Page index. Save it. Now we can restart our application. And after restarting, you can see there is no error, and we can scroll our screen. But every screen has the same data. We want to fix this. So before that, let's simply say item count and change it to 3. And now in this screen widget, create a parameter. So final int index, and here say required this dot index. Save it. Now we have to pass the index. For that, simply index and pass your page index here, and remove this constant. Save it. Now we have to use our method, which is on page change, and here the value contains the index of the current page. So use a set state and change our page index is equal to value. Save it. Let's simply restart our application. So after restarting, go back to your screen widget, and now we can use the widget index also. So here, come back to your image asset and use a dollar sign and pass the index. And here in the title, pass our index, and same goes for the about. Save it. Now if we scroll it, you can see our content is also changing. Now go back to your onboarding, and after the first child of our stack, we have to create a container. So if you remember, we divided the whole 100% into 50%, 50%, and after that we divided the other 50% into 25, 25. So here we have to give its height according to the screen height. So for that, I will create a variable here. Final size is equal to media query dot of context dot size. Now we can use the size variable. So here use the height property, and it will be size dot height into 0. Let's say 20. And width will be size dot width. Save it. Okay, after that use the child property, and in this child property we have to use a column, and in the children we have to display the dots. For that use a row, and in its children use a list dot generate and generate three items, and use a container. Here height will be 8, width will be 8, and use a decoration here, so box decoration, and here use a shape and change the shape to box shape dot circle, and also change the color. So for now color start red, so you can see these are our circles dots. So to make them in center, change the main axis alignment of our row into center. And after that we have to change or add some margin between them. So edge inset starts symmetrical, horizontally we want 8 margin. So okay, now we have to place the whole container here. For that, let me simply position this size box. So positioned, and it will be bottom 0. So here are our dots. After that, in this column and this row we have to create a button. So I will simply use a size box, and here use a child and use an elevated button, and on press will be empty for now. And for this child I will go with the text and say next. Now we have to style it. So text style, and here increase the font. So font size will be 18 and font weight will be bold, will be font weight dot bold. Save it. So this is our button. We can increase the height also, but before that we have to change its color. For that, in your elevated button, use style property and elevated button dot style from, and change the background color to button color, the which we created in our constant file. Now we can change the height and size. For height I will go with 50, and for the width I will go with the size dot width minus 100. So this is our button. Now we have to add space between them. For that, go back to your column and change the main axis alignment to space evenly. So now our UI is completed and only the skip button is remaining. So after this position, use an elevated button again, and empty will be on press for now, and after that text. So I will just simply change this text from here, so, and paste it here. And after that I will change the title in it, so it will be skip, and size will be, let's say, 16. So this is our button. Now we have to style it, so I will just simply copy the style from our next button and paste it here. Okay, now we have to position it here. For that, simply wrap your elevated button into a position widget and say right to, let's say, 30 and top to 50. So okay, now our UI is completed. Now we have to add the functionality. One thing is added that if we scroll it, content is changing. Now on this next button we have to change the page and the content also. For that, go to your next button. We have to use some conditions here that if our page index is equal to 2, do this, else do that. So if our page index is equal to 2, we can navigate to other screens like login or sign up or home screen. Else we have to use our page controller and navigate to next page, and we have to pass the duration of the animation, so that will be milliseconds 600, and the animation will be curve start is in, or you can any animation, so just save it. And now if we click next button from our screen 1, we can navigate to screen 2, and if we press the next button on our screen 2, we can navigate to screen 3, and if we click, we are not navigating because we have to pass the method here. So this thing is done. After that we have to change the content also. So just say if page index is equal to 2, say proceed, else say next, and we have to remove the constant also. And also we have to hide the button when we are on our last screen. For that, here you can use if, and say if page index is not equal to 2, then only show this. So as we are on index 2, the skip button is hidden, and if we navigate back, you can see our skip button. So on press of this skip button, you can navigate to other screens. So I hope everything is done except the dots. If we navigate, we want to change the dots color also. For that, go back to your row, and here in the color property, say if page index is equal to index, use button color, else say background color. And now we have to remove the constant, save it. Now as we are on screen 1, only first dot is colored, and if we change the screen, second dot and then third dot. So now our UI is completed, and you can easily customize it, change your own content, images, everything, and use this on in your application. So I hope you found this video helpful. If you do, please subscribe to the channel and press that bell icon so that you will be notified whenever a new video is uploaded. See you in the next one. Till that, Allah Hafiz.